Shamanic Journey and the Imaginal World of the Psyche by Aion Farvahar. Shamanic Journey is a self-guided expedition into the imaginal world of the psyche, a world where everything comes to life as images. These images are real and far from personal fantasies. They serve a purpose and are meant to bring higher consciousness and self-awareness to those who notice them. Hi, this is Aion Farvahar. I'm glad you're here. If it's your first time here, this channel is about self-realization and honoring our life purpose and meaning. If you're interested in these topics, please subscribe to stay connected. Your support is the foundation of this channel and encourages me to create more content in the future. Today, we want to focus on shamanic journeying, an ancient and sacred wisdom tradition used for thousands of years to access higher levels of human consciousness, the levels that are not accessible to our rational mind. Aside from its ancient roots, shamanic journey is also a psycho-spiritual portal to deeper levels of knowledge, both personal knowledge and more collective or universal knowledge. Knowledge about hidden aspects of our being, buried or suppressed deep within our unconscious. Aspects that once become conscious can lead to our greatest personal transformation and self-awareness. Shamanism is a sacred tradition and must be taught or passed on by qualified shamanic elders. So the goal of this presentation is not to teach shamanism, but rather highlight positive aspects of shamanic journey practice that can benefit anyone who has an inner calling to try it. We will focus on basic elements of a shamanic journey and highlight what makes shamanic journey different than conventional meditation. We will also focus on the imaginal world that is experienced during shamanic journeys. There's also a brief shamanic journey demo toward the end of this presentation, in case you feel comfortable to try it. Here is an outline of the topics we will cover. Links to these topics are provided in the description below, in case you wish to come back to them at a later time. What does make shamanic journey different than meditation? Basic elements of a shamanic journey: boundary, intention, and sonic driver. Shamanic journey and the imaginal world of the psyche, Mundus Imaginalis. And a brief shamanic journey demo. Let's go over these. What does make shamanic journey different than meditation? If you have done meditations before, you probably know that most conventional meditations are designed to unplug your mind from your mundane feelings and thoughts. The goal of most meditations is to achieve a state of presence, calmness, and peace. Shamanic journey is different. In shamanic journeys, the goal is not to achieve peace or calmness, but rather create space inside and turn our attention inward to access deeper levels of insight. These insights are usually related to an intention, which we need to set before starting the journey. These insights can be communicated through meaningful images, symbols, forms, or even somatic sensations. Shamanic journey is unique because it invites intuitive communication and engagement with whatever is present in the journey. In a way, we can think of shamanic journey as a self-guided expedition into the inner dimensions of our being, an expedition that has a heartfelt intention and is meant to bring about higher levels of consciousness and self-awareness. Basic elements of a shamanic journey: boundary, intention, and sonic driver. As mentioned earlier, Shamanic traditions are sacred and unique to specific indigenous cultures and practices. So they need to be honored that way and taught by a shamanic elder of each tradition. The elements of a shamanic journey covered here are generic in nature and are based on my personal understanding and experience. At a basic level, a shamanic journey has the following three elements. Boundaries, including cardinal and temporal boundaries. Intentions, including invitations and inquiries. And sonic drivers, including drums, rattles, and chants. Let's briefly go over these elements. Boundaries, including cardinal and temporal boundaries. A shamanic journey should have symbolic boundaries, including a clear beginning and an end. Attention is given to create a sacred space encompassing all cardinal directions, namely north, west, south, east, and also above and below, recognizing the boundaries of the space we're in by respecting and saluting all the cardinal directions. In addition, smudging is used to define spiritual boundaries. The goal here is to create a sacred space in the room you're in. At the end of the journey, the same attention to these boundaries is needed to close them, so there is a clear beginning and end of the journey. Intentions, including invitations and inquiries. Shamanic journey is sacred and should not be treated as a recreational practice. Its practice should have a life-nourishing purpose. So it is important to have an intention for every journey. This intention could be related to a deeper question you have about your life, your spiritual connection, or an inquiry about something that has been preoccupying your mind. The journey may not always be aligned with your intentions, but there is almost always a message or an insight in there that can be useful in helping you broaden your self-awareness or your perspectives related to that intention. Something that you need to know or recognize in you. Sonic drivers, including drums, rattles, and chants. Shamanic journey also requires a monotonous sonic driver that helps you descend into a state of wakeful awareness, a state that is different from how we usually experience the world. This state is experienced through what I call our inner senses, namely our imagination or our felt sense intuition, in a way similar to a lucid, vivid dream. As in a lucid dream, this wakeful shamanic awareness enables one to access higher consciousness and an intuitive sense of knowing. Sonic driver can be a drum, a rattle, or a chant. Rhythmic movement of the body can also be used to enhance the sonic effects. Examples are dervishes' ceremonial head movement, Sufis' swirling dance, and so on. What is important is not the instrument used as a sonic driver, but the frequency of the sound itself. The most ideal frequency is in theta brainwave range, preferably around 4 to 5 Hz or 240 to 300 beats per minute. This range of sound frequency stimulates electrophysiological brain activity, usually associated with REM sleep, lucid dreams, deep meditative state of awareness, and recollection of visual memories. Sonic driver enables us to turn our attention inside toward the inner world of images and symbols, the world that is also known as shamanic cosmos. Shamanic journey and the imaginal world of the psyche, Mundus Imaginalis. So far, we explained what shamanic journey is and how to practice that. But the more important question is what happens to our consciousness during shamanic journey or when we experience any altered state of consciousness. By its very nature, experience of altered state of consciousness is not something that can be understood by rational thinking. Because of that, a rational mind tries to label such experiences as unreal or dismiss them as personal hallucination, fantasies, or even random recollection of forgotten memories. This explanation may be comforting to someone who has a purely materialistic view of the world. But for others who are spiritual or have personally experienced an altered state of consciousness, this state is far from fantasy and feels even more real than what we usually call reality. Shamanic journey enables us to access an imaginal world, or a world where everything exists as images or in imaginative forms. The use of term imaginal here does not mean imaginary, but rather existing in images. As we humans exist as corporal bodies in the material world, everything in the imaginal world exists as an image, a form, or a symbol. The term imaginal was first coined by Henri Corbin, famous French theologian. Corbin introduced the concept of Mundus Imaginalis, or the imaginal world, a world that exists beyond the ordinary world that we experience through our five senses. The Mundus Imaginalis is a world that is empirically observed through the organ of imagination or imaginative consciousness. C.J. Jung, the pioneer of depth psychology, also exchanged ideas with Henri Corbin and was in fact experiencing an imaginal world himself. Jung's personal experience of the imaginal world and his shamanic awakening are documented in great details in his Red Book and a more recent collection of his Black Books. It is evident in these books that Jung was actively practicing a form of shamanic journey, but he ended up calling it active imagination when he later introduced his depth psychological framework. If you're interested to learn more about the link between shamanism and Jung's work, I strongly recommend a book published by my mentor and psychoshamanic teacher, Dr. C. Michael Smith, titled Jung and Shamanism in Dialogue. I have provided a link to it in the description below. In summary, when we are in a shamanic journey, we are accessing the Mundus Imaginalis and its imaginal content. There is much more to say about shamanic cosmos and the imaginal world, especially spiritual aspects of this world. Some of these aspects include Axis Mundi, spirit guides, spirit animals, guardian spirit, and different levels of consciousness in the shamanic cosmos. I will try to create another presentation in the future, specifically focusing on these aspects. In the meantime, if you're interested to know more about inner guides, guardian spirits, and how to meet your inner guides as a part of a shamanic journey, the links to two of my previous presentations on these topics are provided in the description below. A brief shamanic journey demo. In case you're comfortable in trying a brief shamanic journey, here is an opportunity to do so. If you don't feel as comfortable, you can consider trying shamanic journey later when guided by a shamanic practitioner or an elder. The shamanic journey we try here is an experiential demo and short in duration, about 5 minutes or so. Conventional drum journeys are longer in duration, usually between 15 to 30 minutes. It is best to sit or lay down somewhere you feel fully comfortable. If you can, smudge the room you're in, set boundaries for the journey, and declare its beginning and the end. Shamanic journeys are inner journeys and are best experienced with closed or covered eyes. In this demo journey, our intention is to visit an imaginal forest and explore what is present in there. So when the drumming begins, you are invited to look for an imaginal forest. Once in there, take a minute to look around and see what you notice there. Check if you notice a tree or an animal that presents itself to you or grabs your attention. If nothing immediately is present, send an invitation to the trees and animals of the forest to see if any of them are open to be there with you. If you notice a tree or an animal, check what feeling or insight it communicates, or whether you feel it has an advice or piece of wisdom to share with you. If you receive any intuition or insight from it, make sure you thank it. If nothing is shared, just try to notice your conscious presence in the forest and what is present in there. If time permits, you can improvise and ask for the name of anything that is present, or ask questions that cross your mind. This demo includes about 5 minutes of theta wave drumming. After that, you will notice a slower tempo, which is an invitation for you to say your goodbyes to whatever is present in your journey and get ready to come back. Toward the end, the tempo speeds up again, which invites you to find your way back to present and the room you're in. Start of the journey. Thank you. end of the journey. It is always good to journal your experience after each journey. Shamanic journeys need practice and may not always work perfectly. If needed, repeat this demo later or try longer journeys with your own unique intention. Closing remarks. I hope you have found the information and the Shamanic Journey demo presented here useful. Shamanic Journey is an ancient and sacred art. The best way to relate to it is through personal experience, preferably guided by a shamanic elder. Always check inside to make sure you're fully comfortable before shamanic journeying. It is always good to listen to your feelings when it comes to inner works or psycho-spiritual exploration of your deeper self. When the stars are aligned, your inner callings will guide you toward where you need to be and what you need to discover. So always listen and trust your heart to guide you toward higher states of consciousness. If you have found this presentation inspiring, please like and share it with your like-minded friends. Please subscribe to my channel and share your thoughts and comments. Also, if you have requests for future topics, please share it as a comment or contact me through my bio link below. For more information about myself and life mentorship services I offer, please find my bio link in the description below. Blessings.